Hi guys, good morning. This is a video regarding MyFitnessPal and the use of it so that you're able to get used to the app and get the most of what you're using to help you with your fat loss goals. Now, most of the people who are using MyFitnessPal use it as a food diary so they can know what they're eating per day and then how that over 1 week will equate to their body weight going up or body weight going down. The majority of people is for the body weight to go down. Some people is to maintain the body weight and some people is to actually grow the body weight or increase it. So with this app, it suits everybody and all their body types. All you gotta do is when you sign up, it'll ask you for your details, your height, weight, etc., and your goals. So put that all in and it'll give you a figure up the top. So at the top, you will see here that mine's currently say 2,590 and I've had 195 and I've got this amount left. So that's basically every day you've got this amount of calories to spend. You spend this much on food and that's how much you've got left. So think of it like a balance sheet, okay? So it's all about going in and about, I mean, food going in is you spending money, okay? So keep spending, but don't go into overdraft. That's the most important thing. You can have money left over, but don't go into overdraft. So your main meals are going to be here, of course. You're going to have your breakfast, your snacks, your lunch, etc. Just the way I've set mine up just now is breakfast, snack, lunch, snack, dinner, and maybe another snack. You don't always have to reach your protein goals. So say, for example, you right now you might have 2,500 calories. By 10 o'clock at night, you might still have another 300 left. Don't think, oh, I must meet my target here and eat something else just for the sake of it, because you need to listen to your body first of all. If you already are feeling full, then just stop, okay? Now if you want to still look and see, have you had enough protein or enough carbs, or what did your food all consist of, scroll to the bottom of your main screen and then you will have here it says nutrition. By default, I think it will show a pie chart, so next to it, nutrients, that's when you click on, it'll give you the breakdown of your protein, your carbs and your fat, and then it will tell you in the blue bar how much you've got left of that particular component. Sometimes I might ask you to check that screen, I might ask you to screenshot it for me, so it's quite useful to know how to get to that, okay? That's one thing. Secondly is inputting food. You could have, for example, I've just put in here Weetabix for this morning, okay? So I just press breakfast and I go to add food. And then I can look for my recently added stuff. So, but say you haven't added anything yet and you're quite new to this, then I can put in maybe, let me see if I can find another one that I've had last time, Shreddies, a bowl of Shreddies. You can have like 1 cup of it, you can have 40 grams of it. So using kitchen scales could be a good idea to weigh your food for this moment in time. You can look for, there are some default ones, look for the ones with the green ticks, these are more official. Official ones are verified by the actual manufacturers and they go, yes, well, we have input the nutritional details about our Shreddies and 40 gram with 100 grams of milk, 100 ml of milk does equate to 200. So I would probably trust that and I'll go, okay, I'll choose that one then and tick it. And now that's going to add onto my daily input. So I have 2,590, I have spent 395 and I've got 2,195 left. So that's just mainly carbs though, unfortunately. Okay, so if you're looking for higher protein, you're looking for eggs, chicken, turkey, or whatever else you might eat for breakfast, or even like salmon, smoked salmon, stuff like that. But don't worry, as long as overall in 24 hours you have not gone over your calorie ceiling, and you have a good balance of your carbs, protein and fat, then you should be fine. If you eat all carbs all day and you don't go over your ceiling, yes, you would not be putting on extra weight, okay, if the balance is right. But your protein is lacking for muscle building, so you're going to build less muscle, okay? You're going to recover slower from your workouts. And also you're going to have a lot of maybe like bloatiness or water retention, because carbs tend to do that. It tends to hold on weight for you as well. If you have all protein, right, you have no fats and you have no carbs, which is very difficult to do, you will feel very full quickly and very hard to like kind of keep eating to meet your target if you're doing that. And you will have lack of energy, right? You can have some energy, but you wouldn't have like short bursts of like, you know, glucose and and carbs and sugar from your carb sources, and then your fat's missing as well. So through time, you're going to be needing fats definitely for your skin health, for your hair, for your hormone levels, etc. So it's very important to have a good balance of all three. And if it's a really high fat diet, then that's kind of like Atkins or ketogenic, so people have no carbs at all, then you can feel low energy. You can have high protein, high fat, no carbs, it can't be sustained throughout all of that long time, okay? So you will be finding it difficult to find food choices, but at the same time your calories will be really high too, because fat takes up more room than carbs and protein. So I'll go into more detail with you personally if that's something that you want to look into. But try your best to look for barcodes of things, okay, that you can scan into, so it gives you a bit more accurate details. If you just type in lasagna, for example, or like chicken and rice, there are thousands of entries of all these food components, and it's not always going to be the most accurate one, even though it may have a green tick in it. I would just definitely scan it if I can, okay? If not, just search for it. And if you go to restaurants like Nando's Chicken, etc., ones will open again, you can probably get more details that way. You can look through menu, etc. You can also manually input food, like you can go to quick add, okay? So say you're in Nando's, you're gonna have a salad, you put in quick add, put in, you know, 500 calories for the salad, and then enter, and that's it. So you don't need to worry about finding the particular one, because sometimes you don't want to work your phone out like every single time you're out. But anyway, this is just a short-term thing. It's not going to be forever. There are times that I go off this for months. Like I don't input too much, or not that long. I do use it, but I don't accurately use it like for the whole 24 hours. But it's just a rough idea. So you can, at the end of, say, 2 months, you can start to eyeball things and go, okay, I know those potatoes, five of them equates to 120 grams, so therefore you can input it anyway. You don't need to weigh those potatoes anymore, and you just learn slowly and surely what each thing is, and you can guesstimate, so you have a bit more freedom. But for now, if you're newly starting to this and we're in isolation, so spend more time to get to know the food that you're going to have. You'd be surprised at the supermarket, it can help you change, make different choices and change your mind about certain foods that you bought before. Yep, hope that helps. I'll give you more details on a personal level, but that's just a wee overview, and have a great day, guys.